Did you know that math equations actually can be drawn as a picture? We have to have a way in math that we can draw those pictures. And so mathematicians were very smart and they came up with this concept of the coordinate plane. And the whole purpose of the coordinate plane is it allows us to draw the picture that each equation represents. So today, all we're going to look at is how does the coordinate plane work? As you start to see in advanced math classes, this becomes one of the most important pieces that you'll do all the way up through calculus even. So if we take a look at the coordinate plane first, a plane is just a flat surface that goes in all directions forever and ever and ever. And so mathematicians thought, well, how can we show that? So they thought, oh, we could do it on a number line because a number line also goes in all directions forever and ever and ever. So what they did is they took two number lines. They put one left to right, and we call that the x-axis. And they put one top to bottom, and we call that the y-axis. And so that actually is giving us dimension that we're looking at. Now, what they decided is, okay, when we go and do that, we can see that we have four quadrants. And so they named their quadrants, and they use Roman numerals for the naming of the quadrants. So our positive quadrant was our first quadrant because that's the first place that our number system starts. It's in that positive world. But then they went counterclockwise. So it goes quadrant one, quadrant two, quadrant three, quadrant four. So it's not usually the way you think of it. Think of it going backwards. Now, on the inside the quadrants, notice we have our positive and our negative numbers because those are our number lines. And so every location inside the quadrants can be represented by an ordered pair. And that ordered pair is always an x value represented first and a y value represented second. It gives us that exact location on the coordinate plane. But we needed to identify these points a little bit more. So mathematicians decided that we'll always use a positive letter to show that point. So this point here is represented by A. We call it point A. Now, in order to say its exact location on the coordinate plane, I come down to my x-axis first, and I always go for the x first. So when I come straight down, I can see that position is at 6 on that x number line. So in my ordered pair, I'm gonna always put 6 first for that location. But I have to get the second dimension here as well. And so I can come across from that same point A, and I can see that it touches the y-axis at 5. So that exact location of point A would be the ordered pair 6, 5. Now, B, again, you have to go to your x position first. So I'm going to go straight up from the x, I see it's negative 8. Then I'm going to go across to the y, I see it's negative 3. So that point B is actually location negative 8, negative 3. And we can do that for C, and we can do it for D. So any location within the quadrants can be represented by an ordered pair. But sometimes we have points that actually fall on the axes themselves. So if you see a point on an axis, it's okay. So this point E, if I go across, notice it's at 9 on the x-axis. But when I have to come across to get my y, that y is actually at the 0 point. So on the x-axis, it would be at 9, 0. On the y-axis, remember my x goes first, so that has to be at the position of 0 on my x and negative 5 on my y. So every location within the coordinate plane, whether it's in the quadrants or it's on the axes, can be a location of a point for that. Now, we have a few special points. One of them is what is called the origin. It's where the two axes actually cross, so the x and the y, and it always crosses at the point 0, 0 for that. We'll see some patterns that are coming out in our quadrants. We'll notice that no matter what, our x and our y values are always positive when we're in quadrant one. Our x and y value in quadrant two, well, our x is negative always, our y is always positive. In quadrant three, both our x and our y will always be negative. In quadrant four, our x will be positive, and our y will be negative. The more that you graph, pretty soon you can just look at an ordered pair and you'll know if it's in quadrant 1, 2, 3, or 4. And that's when you're getting really good with the coordinate plane. So today you're gonna be given some points. You're either gonna be asked to graph it within the coordinate plane, or you're gonna have to be able to read a point and identify the ordered pair that goes with it. So the key concept is you must always put the x first, followed by the y. If you reverse it, you're gonna be in a different quadrant of the coordinate plane. So have some fun graphing today. The coordinate plane will be our crucial piece as we move forward, but it's kind of fun to start to draw in math. Good luck.